Hello everyone, welcome to CareerDeed Training Solutions. Myself Mohan and we are at session 2 of DA. In previous video, we discussed about a DA problem on pie chart. In this session, we are about to learn problem based on bar graph. Here, you have a typical problem on bar graph which is based on profit and loss concept. So, you have a bar graph illustrating selling price, profit percentage of three articles A, B and C. Numbers mentioned in blue line is selling price and number mentioned in red line is profit percentage. If you take article A, 348 rupees is selling price and profit percentage is 50. For article B, 261 is selling price and profit percentage is given in minus. So minus means the transaction is loss. If you take article C, 528 is selling price and 32 is profit percentage. If you have watched my videos on profit and loss, this problem is going to be simple. However, let me explain the same concept one more time. Cost price is always 100%. Imagine you are purchasing a product for 200 rupees. So this 200 rupees is the amount moving from your end, right? So this 100% is nothing but 200 rupees. So 200 is cost price, which is 100%. And you are selling the same product for 300 rupees. And we can say this 300 rupees is selling price. Now from this 200 rupees to 300 rupees, how much is our profit? 100 rupees. Now this 100 rupees is our profit and this 100 rupees came from the cost price 200 rupees. So this 100 is how many percentage of 200? Only 50%. So selling price is how many percentage? 100 plus 50, we get 150%. So 150% is selling price of the article where 50% is profit and for 200 rupees, 100% is the cost price. We are going to apply the same protocol for this problem. If you take, for example, if you take article A, 348 rupees is selling price. So the selling price is how many percentage with profit, which is 50%, right? So selling price is 150%. Here, the selling price is 100 minus 13, 87%. For article C, 100 plus 32, 132%. Now, let us enter into first question. What is cost price of article B? We know selling price is 261 rupees. If I sell the article for 261 rupees, I will get a 13% loss, which is only 87% of cost price. If you want to find cost price, which is 100%, so 100% equal to X. Just cross multiply, you get X equal to 261 by 87 into 100. 261 is 87 times of 3 times of 87, so 3 into 100 you get 300. So cost price of article B is 300 rupees. Hope you understood the problem, right? Moving to second problem of this model. Cost price of article B is how much percentage higher or lesser comparing to article C? We know article B is 300 rupees from previous problem. Now we have to find cost price of article C. We know selling price is 528 rupees with profit 32%. So 132% is nothing but 528. So if 132% is 528, we have to find 100%. So 100% equal to X. While you cross multiply, you get 132 into 4, 528. So 4 into 100, 400. So 400 is the cost price of article C. Now obviously article B is 100 rupees lesser comparing to article C, because in question it is given cost price of article B is how many percentage higher or lesser, so which is lesser, right? How many rupees lesser? 100 rupees lesser comparing to article C. You are comparing with article C, right? So article C have to come in denominator. So 100 by 400 into 100, so which is 1/4 of 100, 25%. So article B is 25% lesser comparing to article C. So answer for the question is 25%. Now moving to third question of this model. What will be the selling price of article B to gain the same percentage of profit incurred in the loss? So article B incurred with the loss of 13%. For how many rupees the person have to sell the article to gain the same percent of profit incurred in loss? So if loss is 13%, he have to gain same 13%. For that he have to sell the article for 113%. 100 plus 13, 113%. And the information we know is only 87%. So 87% is selling price here, which is 261 rupees. So if 87% is 261 rupees, what is 113%? Just cross multiply, you get 3 times. So 3 into 113, you get 339 rupees. So if the person sell the article for 339 rupees, he will get a 13% profit. If he sell the article for 261 rupees, he will get the same loss of 13%. Hope you understood the problem, right? Now moving to second model of the session. And in second model, which is similar to the first model, but here the production of fertilizers by the company over the years is given, but here the each data is given in the unit of 1000 tons. If you take in 2005, the production of fertilizers is 25,000 tons, and in 2006, 40,000 tons, in 2007, 60,000 tons, in 2008, 45,000 tons, in 2009, 65,000 tons, in 2010, 50,000, and next 75,000, and in consecutive years, 80,000 tons. You were provided with 8 years data. Now our first question is, in how many of the given years was the production of fertilizers more than the average production of the given years? So first you have to find the average production of the fertilizers for this 8 years, and you have to find in how many years the production is greater than the average production. So let us add 25 plus 40 plus 60 plus 45 plus 65 plus 50 plus 75 plus 80, we get 440. So 440 is the total production of fertilizer over all these years. To find average, you have to divide it by 8, because we have 8 consecutive years, right? So 440 by 8, we get 55. So 55 is the average production of fertilizers. So in how many years the production is greater than 55? In 2007 it is greater, in 2009 it's greater, in 2011 it is greater, in 2012 it is greater. So in 4 years the production is greater than the average production. So here answer for the particular question is 4 years. Hope that you understood the concept, right? Moving to second question of this video. What was the percentage decline in production of fertilizers from 2007 to 2008? Comparing to 2007, 2008 is how much lesser? 60,000 tons minus 45,000 tons, 15,000 tons lesser comparing to 2007. So in 2007 the production is 60, right? So which is how many percentage? We know 15 by 60 is 1/4, so 1/4 of 100 is 25%. So from 2007 to 2008 the production is 25% lesser, or we can say 25% declined. Now moving to last question of this model. This question is really important question. In which year was the percentage increase in production as compared to the previous year the maximum? So here you don't need to work for all the years, you have to consider only the options. If you take in 2002 comparing to 2011, which is how many percentage higher? So comparing to 2011, 2012 produced 5000 tons extra, right? So 5000 tons comparing to 2011, which is 75. So 5 by 75 you get 1 by 15. Now in 2009 comparing to 2008, how much higher? 45 to 65, which is 20,000 tons higher comparing to 2008. So in 2008 it is 45,000 tons, so which is equivalent to 4 by 9. In 2011 comparing to 2010, how many tons higher? 25,000 tons higher comparing to 2010. So in 2010 it's only 50,000 tons, so which is 1 by 2. And in 2006, comparing to 2005, how many tons higher? 15,000 tons higher comparing to 2005. So in 2005, it's 25,000 tons, so which is equivalent to 3 by 4. Now to solve this, you don't need to multiply by 100. So if you know the percentage equivalent fraction, which I taught you in percentage, this is going to be simple. We know the value of 1 by 5's equivalent percentage is 6.66%. And you know 1 by 9 is 11.11%, so 4 by 11 is 4 into 11.11%, you get 44.44%, and 1 by 2 is nothing but 50%, right? So let me write here 50%, and it's not actually 3 by 4, it's 3 by 5, right? While cancelling in fifth table we get 3 by 5. So 1 by 5 is 20%, so 3 by 5 is 60%, so answer is 60%. Now which is higher? Obviously 60% is higher, right? So this is 6.66, and here 50%, 44.44%, and here you get 60%. So 60% is the value of 2006. So option for the question is 2006. So in 2006, the percentage increase in production as compared to the previous year was maximum. Hope you understood all the problems of this video, right? So let us practice more question on that so that you will get a better understanding about data interpretation in upcoming videos. Now thanks a lot for watching. Before winding up this video, as I said before, please do subscribe to our channel, click the bell button to get instant notification, like the video, and if you have any doubt, please post it on the comment section below. Don't forget to share the video to your friends. Have a nice day.